Hello visual effects people, I'm AK and this is FluidNinja. We are going to cover container materials, how to use your big data in scene. The major topics that we are covering is how to generate container materials, what frame blending options we have, how to handle transparent materials and masking, colorizing your materials and some special features. Please note that the relationship between cascade particles and the baked data and how to drive the playback of the baked data is going to be covered in a different chapter. So I'm quickly exiting this level, going to the Ninja tools, and full screen, and let's bake something quickly called Flame-O. It's going to be 16 frames. Here we go. Please note that these user interface elements popped actually are related to the baking and the exporting of the data. And most importantly, we have these three buttons here: saving the baked flipbook as Unreal texture asset, because right now it is in the memory, and with this, by pressing this button, I'm saving it to the disk as an actual file, as an Unreal asset. And I'm also saving materials, which are going to contain this baked flipbook data, and these are going to be used to play it in our scene. Okay, so I'm quitting Ninja and going to the content browser, and let's see what we have in the output folder. We have a density map, it's 4x4 flipbook. We have a velocity map. And we have two materials, the basic player and the advanced player. Let's have a look at the basic player first. 16 frames is not too much. And when you're playing it during 2 seconds, as you could see, we have a very cartoony, jaggery look as we are jumping from one frame to the next. What if I switch on interpolation, linear interpolation, the blending between the frames? Here you could see this interpolation options, and I'm pressing this bool button. It's a little bit better, but still I could see how frames are fading to the next. So I would like to show you this velocity interpolation. Have a look at this jaggery thing. When I'm pressing velocity interpolation, suddenly it becomes smooth. And what happened is the following. Since these data are generated by a simulation, we have a very good approximate information how certain spots, how certain pixels of density are moving in this simulation space, and that is recorded into the velocity map. So by using velocity interpolation, we are using exactly this data and telling each pixel where to go. We are actually doing some UV offset based on this velocity data, but the result is a very smooth playback, and we have a very low number of stored frames, so it's an advantageous feature, and it's not part of the standard Unreal flipbook playing kit. This comes with FluidNinja, and it is called velocity interpolation. All right, let's have a look at the advanced material. Advanced material is made to actually apply the baked data in your scene. As you could see, the major difference between the basic player and the advanced player that we have something that is already masked. And the thing is that we are using the luminance information to mask the density data, which means the brighter a pixel is, the more opaque it will be. Let's have a look at the structure of this advanced material. As you could see, we have at least 10 groups of options here: basic, color, interpolation, and let's start with opacity. Here's this thing called alpha strength. I'm just grabbing the slider, and you could notice how the transparency and the mask strength is changing by moving this slider. You could adjust that in your scene. By the way, if you're just drag and dropping this advanced material to a geometry in your scene, you could do it on the fly. So while you're adjusting these parameters, you could see the baked data in your location of application, so on the spot where you are using this data. So much about alpha strength. What other options we have for alpha? Have a look at this edge mask thing. What if I set alpha strength to an extreme? You see? On the top of the flipbook sequence, basically the simulated data is reaching the borders and we have this bad looking edge. Now, if I switch on edge masking, it's gonna take a few seconds to recalculate the shader. You see, the strange border thing disappeared, which means in a normal case, you have to be careful to position your density data and your particles in the middle of the recorded field. But if you made some mistakes or for some reason it is reaching the borders, you could mask it with this edge mask thing. Returning to the normal alpha strength value, which is, let's say, 10. Yeah, this is looking fine. What are the options we have for opacity? Well, most importantly is depth fade. You might notice from the normal Unreal materials, when your geometry or particle is meeting another geometry, there might be a hard edge, and with depth fade you could basically create a soft mask and avoid these hard edge intersections between geometries. Right on, so much about opacity. What else do we have? We have the same options as in the basic material for influencing play speed. And as you could see, we have a few more options here. These are to drive your bake sequence playback by a blueprint or by a cascade particle. We're gonna talk about this later on. Right now we are just examining this looped sequence. What do we have? Texture parameter values. You have the flipbook input, the density and the velocity map. And let's move on to color. What if I would like to colorize this monochromatic data we have generated? Well, we have three options for that. Color 1, 2, 3. Let's say I'm just modifying color 1. And we have this yellowish hue. And in the linear color space, I could boost it to make it look like a glowing flame ball by multiplying this value by 1000. And let's have a look at this contrast slider. As you could see, we are applying a power function here, and the highlight zone could be influenced. So the time has come to add the second color, and you could imagine the second color as a tone mapping. So the darker pixel is going to be mapped with this second color. And let's give a few seconds to Unreal to calculate this material instance. And let's give a value to this second color. Let's make a reddish hue and give it a multiplier by 200. And let's just tweak the contrast slider. So you could see we did the tone mapping with two colors. Color 1 is a yellowish hue and color 2 is a reddish one. And right now the contrast is basically doing a balance between the two, and we are tone mapping this grayscale simulation information. Right on. So we have this thing here. And what if I would like to add some heat distortion to make it look like a real flame? Well, here's this option, refraction. Just switch it on. Again, a bit of shader recalculation. And here we go. What if I make the whole thing completely transparent? Yeah. You could see what this refraction map does. And you could adjust the strength of it. But it helps when you would like to create something which looks like a flame. what other options we have. Here's a geometric distortion. Have a look at this. We have our texture mapped on a plane. You might spot this 4x4 quad. And if I switch on geometric distortion, I'm able to modify the geometry of this base mesh. As you could see, the mesh is already distorted by the luma information, and this helps a little bit to fake that the whole thing is in 3D. Okay, we covered interpolation, opacity. Okay, what is the third color option for? It's to make color gradients. And to demonstrate this, I'm going to visit the use cases level. Yep, levels, use cases. Here we go. Have a look at this waterfall example. And let's check the material of this waterfall thing. I'm just clicking on the geometry. And I'm going to check the material. As you can see, the third color is used here. And why the first and the second color is for tone mapping, third color is for making a spatial gradient, like a bottom up or a side to side gradient. It's very good to create flames and colorful smoke columns and clouds. So it is a bit different from tone mapping. Right on. I guess we have covered the basic functions of the advanced material: interpolation, playback speed, opacity, and later on we're gonna get to the particle usage. It's very important when creating non-looped sequences. But this is enough for now, I guess. And see you next time. Bye bye.